The hit mobile game series Bleach Brave Souls is a dead game, or how I thought in 2020 when I didn't believe there was any content to go with it, and understandably so, as there was, you know, no anime and there was only so many Thousand Year Blood War characters you could really do, and really thought it had a lifeline or a life expectancy of maybe about 2, maybe 3 years at most. And clearly, going back to that video that I did back in 2020, is completely wrong. So I'm kind of doing a little bit of an update video on why Bleach Brave Souls may actually be a game that may actually encourage more Bleach content in the future outside of the game, and may actually have another 10 year anniversary ahead of it, or maybe even more, considering a game such as Dragon Ball Dokkan Battle has already been confirmed to have 10 more years of content. And you have to question why. Today with me, I have the one, the only, one of my favourite Bleach Brave Souls YouTubers, Aaron Yero. Give yourself a little bit of a shout out, buddy.
Hello, lads. It is thou, the BBS World Champ.
I mean, that wasn't really the intro that I was expecting, you know. All right, lads. There we go.
There you go.
And for some reason, the number one Giselle simp, but we won't talk about that.
We'll talk about it more when the anime.
Who you stand more, Aaron Yero or Giselle?
No comment in it.
So in 2020, I made that video basically because I kind of got off a bit of a hype with Seven Deadly Sins Grand Cross and seeing the 3D modeling of it, seeing the intros that they were doing and seeing the overall world building of that game. And I kind of was a little bit salty and a little bit, again, in my fanboy mode of playing that game and wondering why BBS couldn't really hold up to that fact. And I think BBS has held up to that fact, of course, me being proven me wrong, is because of, well, it has the community and also a development team that actually listens. Maybe a little bit too much sometimes, especially with their open communication such as Discord and Twitter, and even the live streams to a certain extent. And that's not to say that other mobile games don't do that, just maybe from my perspective that is generally the case. Do you believe in that? Or
definitely, yeah.
If you guys don't know, Bleach Brave Souls really, I believe, gained its popularity due to the fact that the Bleach anime hadn't come, and it was the only thing that we could have tangibly to support the anime or the IP, and thus I believe that people played this game in hopes that it would bring back the Bleach anime, and to which we found out after years of playing that in fact the case. But now that the anime is returned, why do people play it? I mean, I can speak for myself, but I'd rather hear why Aaron still plays this game.
It's a tough question, you know. It's a tough question. Obviously, the gameplay is fun. Not to compare it to other gacha games, but it's very smooth. Like, the characters, the gameplay, the mechanics and stuff like that. Even though sometimes it can be quite basic, and a lot of the times the characters can play somewhat the same, it just feels exciting and different and fun when you get your hands on someone new.
Is that because it's like your favorite characters, or do you think they're consistently changing mechanics to keep it refreshing?
A bit of both. Since the fifth anniversary, the power creep has been a bit much, not too much. I think the pace is quite fine. So they always find ways to somehow make these characters new and exciting again, even 7 years later, right? We're getting the new seventh anniversary characters, Uryu coming out with new mechanics. That's definitely, you know, something that we've never seen before. Even 7 years later, they're coming up with new ways to make the game still somehow, some way, feel fresh.
No, I absolutely completely agree with that. I often wonder why I still play this game, and I think it's due, for me personally, just the passion of wanting to summon for my favorite characters. And even without the summoning aspect, could I still play this game? Sure, it does have validity to keep me interested for quite a time based off like quality of life updates alone, which I do want to kind of address. But before I do address those things and the future of BBS, I actually want to talk about the criticisms first. I don't know about you, Aaron, but one of my criticisms is, to begin with, Soul Tickets, Arena, and Chronicle Quest. I think that these are the three major factors, and they kind of bundle all together in terms of Soul Tickets, and that being you have only about 50, or if you paid for the pass, which you have 60, is that there is only so many things, such as Chronicle Quest, for example, where it is a huge farm. It is a dedicated thing for the day if you want to continue with Chronicle Quest to get those items, and then maybe you haven't done story, or maybe you need some more units and you have to do Cons Bonanza, or maybe even your lottery quests. So it's like you have to kind of sacrifice one quest for another, and I feel like, you know, maybe that there's not, in this day and age, BBS anyway, I don't think there is enough soul tickets. Maybe boost it up to 100 and maybe 120 for maybe passport users, because I just maybe don't think that there is a replayability on a day-to-day basis based off of the fact that they keep introducing game modes which do invest more of those soul tickets, which maybe I believe are a bit more dated now.
It's definitely become a problem, especially since we got the 10 times soul ticket update. You're literally on the game for like potentially 5 minutes and you're basically done. Essentially, in some way, shape or form, we're back to in 2016 where we only had 5 soul tickets. There definitely is a lot to do and it can be a bit rough. I find myself spending orbs quite often in soul tickets. I'm quite used to that at that point, but I can definitely see a free-to-play player or someone that doesn't really want to do that. It can be quite daunting. At one point, it might feel like we don't have much to do, but then at some point, it's like we have too much to do and you don't know where to spend those soul tickets, right?
Exactly, yeah. You have to sacrifice one for the other, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, again, you could play Arena for a few hours, sure, but by the time that you finish with Arena, you haven't really recharged enough soul tickets either. So it's like, oh, you might have recharged 5. It's like, oh, okay, well, I've just spent that in like less than a minute, especially if you've got OP units. You've just used that in a minute and now you've got to wait another, what, 5 hours for maybe 20 soul tickets, maybe 30. So, I mean, if you're not going to up the soul ticket usage or increase the amount that you get, at least increase the recharge, I believe, anyway. Something else that I believe you and Spy have also mentioned in videos as well is the Chronicle Quest. There is the drop rates for the medals that you get are just simply not enough to justify really going hard on them.
Yeah, Chronicle Quest is in a bad position. It's been in a bad position for many years now at this point. We luckily got the 10 times soul ticket update, which makes the grinding bearable just because it speeds up the process, but it's definitely not the solution, right? One of the many ideas people have for that particular game mode is two simple ones. Either one, change the soul tickets so that particular quest takes its own type of ticket, certain Brave Battles, has its own type of recharge. That would definitely be a way for people to do their Chronicle Quest daily at that point, or just simply increase the drop rate because it's so inconsistent. Sometimes you can get a decent amount, a lot, and then sometimes you get like 7 and it doesn't really make a dent to the amount of medals and stuff that you have to farm every single month.
Yeah, there is certain things that I do like though, where you have certain parts that do certain discounts. For example, like you can get Soul Reaper scrolls for like 5 medals instead of the average 10, which is quite nice because you tend to focus on more of those rather than the other ones, which are nice when that recharges. But overall, yeah, like Chronicle Quest for me at the moment is probably the most time consuming and the most frustrating, and I'd rather spend much more time on maybe the lottery and start like grinding for maybe those Brave Soul tickets, especially with the new 10 runs. Arena, I could go with or without personally. I don't really think there's a justification for it for me personally, nor do I find it that much of a fun game mode, but I believe other people do, so I'm kind of impartial with that. I've got really no issues with Arena. I've kind of accepted how its style is at this moment, and compared to when I did the video in 2020, when Unohana was the broken unit for the past year at that point, 2019 to 2020, and the mechanic was a bit, you know, screwed on that, I feel like they've made enough characters now to have a good amount of balance within the Brave Battles content. What do you think about that?
Brave Battles has definitely seen a very good change, especially when compared to the 5th anniversary, more specifically when we started to have a bunch of invincible characters. That was a very toxic meta, and then there was 3 of them at one point, so it was like if you didn't have these characters, it just wasn't fun. Since then, of course, we've had new metas and new type of Brave Battle characters, but they've all been actually quite balanced to the point that I think Brave Battles is actually in a really good position. I think it's quite fun. The meta's better than ever. Somehow, they actually somehow fixed that. And we should potentially be getting a new Brave Battle character this month. And that might further push the healthy meta, is what I want to call it.
And I think that's better than incorporating maybe what we were expecting a few years ago when they said that they were going to improve the Brave Battles a lot better. We were kind of expecting a new kind of mode, or a new kind of metric, so to say, or a system. When in fact, they just, with quality of life updates, with better units, have managed to balance it out and make it better. And I think that's the best route to go for, is like making the game improvements rather than just adding more content to the game and making more things broken in that sense and more unplayable. So I did like that about Kalab's choice there. Do you think there's an overkill in banners for one player to choose from, or do you think more options are good rather than less?
I think more is good to a certain extent. I think it depends on the mum, because sometimes they throw a lot of banners and like it's easily skippable. Then sometimes it's more so when Burn the Witch comes out. They normally drop that at a very bad time. That it really sucks if you don't have the character and you're trying to go for them, and then by summoning on that banner, you kind of miss out on other banners. So I think it just depends on the mum. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad. Just really depends how much bait banners they want to throw at us, right?
In terms of quality of life, what would you like to see improved on?
Oh. Where do I begin? Yeah. Nah, they've done quite a bit. They've done quite a bit. More specifically though, it's epic raids. There's a few things that other parts of the game have that other parts just don't. One best example I think I could give is Arena. There's like a loading set where you can put accessories and links. You can load it, save that set. They've already confirmed they're now adding that to a co-op and epic raid. Arena actually has a few quality of life updates that just other parts of the game just don't have, like the replay button, for example. The re-rolling obviously got a lot better when it comes to the accessories. That was something that we were actually begging for many
absolutely.
Years.
Absolutely, yeah, I forgot about that one. That's a banger.
Yeah, that was a really good one. And then you have the familiars. If you've done the familiars recently, it takes so long. You have to do one at a time. You know, with the character soul tree, you can just press one button and complete it. For some reason, the familiar one just hasn't been updated yet. It's still one at a time, and it's just super, super slow. So that's definitely one.
You wouldn't imagine like that would take so long to implement either.
They have things in the game in other parts. They just need to implement it into other parts. So it's just fully complete.
Just copy and paste the code, innit?
Basically, yes.
As you said about the accessory rerolls, I think that's probably, as well as the 10 soul tickets, probably the best updates in the game as of recently. The biggest time consumers has been fixed, and I'm so happy about that. Do you think they should stop at 10, or do you think they should increase it only if they increase the soul tickets?
I think 10 is enough, yeah. I think I would like to have 10 in co-op quests.
That will come eventually, obviously.
Hopefully.
They've always been delayed on that, haven't they?
Because they mentioned it before. I don't think anybody remembers it. They did address the idea of skip tickets. They did say something on the lines of, it's an action game at the end of the day. They want people to play the game. They don't want people just to go in and be done within 5 minutes, right? Or just skip the quest. They want you to actually play the game and work on your characters. So I think 10 is probably the max we're going to see for a very long time.
Here's an interesting question for you. Now that Dokkan has been confirmed to have at least 10 years of more content, how long do you think Bleach Brave Souls has?
Oh, I mean, we lasted like 6 years without an anime. I feel like we could potentially do it again, especially if after the anime does finish. I think it really depends on the anime. So the anime is probably going to go on for 2 years, right?
Around
2 years. That would get us closer to like the 10th anniversary. At that point, they can do things. They can just work with that and just re-release the 1,000-year Bloodwork characters again. I think a lot of people would be excited for that. You know, there is the potential chance of us getting seasonal characters from the 1,000-year Bloodwork. If we were to get some seasonal characters like Bambietta, Giselle.
Ooh. Oh, okay.
That would spice them up, the seasonal banners too, because the seasonal banners nowadays usually are always around the same characters. You know, most of the female characters, it's always the same faces. So all these new characters coming in the final arc, if we can get that, that can definitely like long out the game, like the game's lifespan. Again, also comes down to maybe if the anime want to adapt Can't Feel Your Worlds, if Kubo starts doing something with the Hell Arc, that can obviously keep the game just going. So I think we got a while ahead of us.
Yeah, I was really thinking about this as well, because it's like if Bleach Brave Souls was a contributor factor to the anime, which I believe very much so it was, because of just little things here and there. We're not going to get into that, it's too long. If that is the case, and there is big support for the anime, which I believe there will be, and there is big support for the Bleach Brave Souls games, which clearly 7 years is no laughing feat. I mean, me and you both have seen so many carbon copies of Bleach games over the past few years.
Naruto Voltage, bro.
Yeah, not even that. I'm talking about like the knockoff ones as well, like the Chinese ones and the
mobile
3D version. The mobile 3D, we had the line version of the game, Paradise Lost, and things like that. And they just haven't gone the test of time. It's always been BBS that's always came out on top. And obviously, we've discussed those reasons of why we believe that that's the case. And Shueisha are very well knowledgeable of that as well. I mean, even giving us the 1,000-year Blood War characters before the anime was even, you know, announced is a detriment to how popular Bleach Brave Souls is and how much it is turning a profit. So I believe that, you know, if this game on its own, and I think it is a massive contributing factor, and I want to make that very apparent. This game needs content to survive. It's business at the end of the day. And if they've done the 1,000-year Blood War arc, and they've completed the story in the game, and they've done all the characters, and, you know, they can do the seasonal stuff like you said, they're going to want more content. Okay, well, they've already done Adult Ichigo and Adult Rukia. Let's do the Hell stuff. Okay, so we've got the Hell stuff, right? We've got some Hell units. Xyloporo, Ichigo, Kazui, Ichika. But what about the 10-year time skip? You know, what about the parts in between that? And I believe that that's where K-Lab, not themselves will be going, but where the anime will go to give content to Bleach Brave Souls. just like how Dragon Ball Dokkan or Dragon Ball Legends is a big powerhouse in the mobile game because of the anime, because of these new units. You sometimes even have times where, you know, you have Broly or Cell in the new movies have units or be used as marketing tools to push those movies or anime characters. So I think that that's where BBS is going in terms of with Bleach. And again, you don't want to stop a moneymaker. So I believe that that's where the future is for Bleach Brave Souls.
Gonna be fun. It's gonna be fun. This is the first time we're ever gonna have the Bleach Brave Souls run alongside the anime. Kind of scary too, not really sure exactly where they're gonna go with it, but it's definitely something to look forward to, especially for Bleach fans, or mainly BBS fans, for those that are playing the game, because this is something that we've been obviously calling for many years, and we had a little taste of the Thousand Year Blood War characters, and then suddenly they just stopped for like 2 years. I've been waiting for certain characters, and it's going to be a good day when they finally come to the game now that the anime is coming back.
I'm going to say this now, so in 2 years later we can look back on this to see if it's true, but I'm going to call a banner here and say the seasonal banner for weddings. And the catalyst towards this will be We Do Not Always Love You with Ruki and Renji's little wedding going on. And that will be the catalyst to invent or introduce a new seasonal banner. And we will get wedding dress with Ruka, and I will be all for it.
It's not happening. It could. Ruka gets a lot of seasonals. It could.
Yes, sir.
If they give us Yodoichi, I'm fine with it.
I mean, there's lots, right? Like, just give all the girls wedding dresses, innit? Cool. I think that that's everything we kind of really wanted to talk about in terms of, like, the future of BBS and why I was wrong 2 years ago. So, with that being said, in the link in the description down below, you will see Aaron's channel. If you are a big fan of the Bleach Brave Souls game and you like content regarding to it, go check out his channel. Get him to 50k. That would be very poggers.
50k and, soon, lads.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And tell me you guys' thoughts in the comment section down below of why you still play Bleach Brave Souls and what you consider is going to be the future for this game. That being said, though, I'm going to catch you guys out. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been handsome as always, people. Peace out.